understand is just how to talk to somebody. Okay? You're full blown hot from the gates.
Oh, I wonder where that comes from. Get me riled up, be like, turn on the camera.
I gotta turn that camera on because it's gotta catch when you're just your nonsense.
Stupid.
You need to learn to talk to people. You ain't getting any younger. You don't need to be stuck in your ways being a miserable old person. You can't talk to people. I'm like, hey, you're going to drink this water?
I have been drinking that water! I've been drinking it!
I'm like, it's on the floorboard.
Are you dumb? You're dumb! You won't drink your water!
Don't worry about me. We're talking about you right now. You flipped the script. Welcome to Wolf Tick Videos, and today is a very important day.
Yeah.
I thought you were talking crap already.
I might be.
Today is a very important day. We have hit 3,000 subscribers. How awesome is that?
3,000.
And just wanted to say a very big thank you to you guys out there. 3,000. I knew eventually if the channel caught on, we would be there. It makes us feel good that you guys are out there enjoying our content still and still subscribing. So if you haven't hit that subscribe button and you want to see what this is all about, the Mongoose Malus you can see right here behind me. You guys want to see what it's all about, see us take it on the trail, do a trail review on it, and see what our channel has to offer, please hit that subscribe button. You won't regret it. Hopefully you won't regret it. I don't know.
They might. There's a lot of people that just will not watch the beginnings of our videos.
Yeah, so. You don't want to watch the beginning? That's fine.
Skip ahead.
Yeah, you can skip ahead. You don't have to watch that part.
We're not for everybody. Hell, we're not even for us sometimes.
But hopefully that number keeps on going up. But let's go ahead and get into what we got here. We're going to go ahead and break into it. Normally that's what I'd say. I was waiting for the cue there. You still drinking the Foster's?
Yeah, our Australian...
Counterparts
or Australian viewers are
a lot of Australian viewers.
Yeah, and you know what? They make a good beer.
Yeah. I would normally say break into it and this bike would be in a box, but we got lucky and found one. I was at work, he came, or I call him every day when I'm at work, I call him, see how he's doing. And he had told me, he's like, son, I'll tell you what, I just went to Conway and we have got to go back after you get to work. And I was like, well, what's up? I knew it was a bike. But I was like,
because I had the car, not the truck.
Yeah, I said, well, where exactly did you see this bike at? And he goes, well, you know it's a bike. And I said, of course I know it's a bike. That's all we talk about these days. And I said, Academy? He goes, yep. And I was thinking, well, we already have two Ozones. I'm kind of hoping it's a different brand or something. And he wouldn't tell me what bike it was. I got off work. We went into there. I looked to my left, right where the bikes were, and I seen this beast. And I
I said, you won't miss it if it's still there.
Yeah.
Because I saw the tire sticking out. And then also, you've been wanting a fat tire bike for a while.
I've been wanting a fat tire bike. It never really snows in Arkansas, but if it does this winter, I'll be taking this bike out and hitting up some snow trails, because I guess that's what it's for, right? Snow and sand. But all I know is it's a hardtail. There's no suspension in the front.
It's a rigid bike.
So it's a rigid bike. All the suspension is dependent upon how much pressure you want to put in the tires. Anyway, I seen this bike and I automatically fell in love with it. I've been wanting a fat tire for so long. So I was like, man, perfect. 3,000 subscribers, 3,000 subscriber bike. Normally it goes for $329, at least that's what we found it for. And it's got some really cool stuff to it and I'm excited. So what do you guys say we can... let's take it to the shop and weigh it. It's massive. It's a steel frame. It is heavy.
Oh, I bet the thing's 50 pounds.
Yeah, taking it up here to the deck.
But it doesn't matter with that bike.
No, it doesn't matter with this bike. Let me see your knife. I've been waiting to take this tag off. I can't even ride it around. We've had it a little bit now.
You should just ask me, do you have your knife? Because that's what you always do.
But let's take it to the shop and dive into it. And, I don't know, do a little once over and show you guys what it has to offer. We're going to learn together on this one. It's got some cool stuff you can see up there on the bottom tube. All right, now that we're in the shop, I will tell you, I lifted this thing up and put it on my bike stand, and holy crap, that thing is heavy. Trying to get up there by myself, was a chore, and here in a second, or here in a little bit, we're going to weigh the bike, and that's going to be even more of a chore because it's up here, and there's just a strap. I don't know where I'm going to strap it to. We're going to find out exactly how much this bike weighs, and man, our 3,000 subscriber bike. So just thank you guys so much for being a part of our channel and getting us here, and let's see where this channel can go with the Wolf Tick Nation. If you guys are interested in the Malus, make sure you guys subscribe, turn the notifications on, because over here, and we're going to find out here at the end of the video, I have some awesome upgrades. Don't fast forward. We got to watch this whole segment, and then we'll get to my upgrades over here, and I got some more stuff in the mail. This bike is going to be our campground bike, just like the Nishiki Men's Pueblo. It's going to be, I can see me with a fishing pole strap back here like I do with the Nishiki, a light on the front, maybe a blinker light up on the back. I don't know. What do you guys think? I think it's going to be a great just cruising around bike, cruising around the campgrounds and bashing it, and those upgrades are really going to help in that department as well. But before we start tearing it down too much, I want you guys to hear this. Ready? That awesome roar. It's just so loud. It just sounds like it's, making an entrance. Not like that. But let's go ahead and start talking about the drivetrain with the Malus. Now, the front chainring up here is a 36 tooth. It's not a narrow, wide, nothing fancy, just a simple chainring. There are some upgrades you can do to this, actually, I have found. For about $100, you can make this bottom bracket here, which is a tapered bottom bracket. You can make it a hollow bottom bracket. That might be an upgrade in the future that we're looking at doing, at least I want to do. I don't know about so much about my dad. We'll have to see how the bike goes and how the build is, but it does have a Cam C chain. And on the rear back here, it has a 14 to 28 tooth free wheel. It's not a free hub, so you can't change that cassette out, but a 14 to 28, more geared for, I guess, like a road use, you know, and kind of going fast as opposed to climbing. And this bike is definitely going to be used for that. The rear derailleur is a Shimano Cherny derailleur, 6 to 7 speed, it says on there. And the shifter is just it's an unbranded shifter. It's a 7 speed twist shifter, you know, and it feels kind of comfortable. I don't know. I don't really dig twist shifters, but for this style of bike, that whole twist shifter deal kind of might play in its favor, just because I'm not going to be looking for quick shifts constantly while I'm climbing mountains and things like that. One really cool thing with this bike that it has, it being a budget bike, I never would have expected it, is it has the internally routed shifter table. I think that's the coolest thing, you know, whenever you're going through the woods. And we keep mentioning this bike is going to be going through the woods. Just less stuff to snag on is going to be nice up here. And I think it's a pretty cool touch. Some of the older models, you don't see that. All right, so let's go ahead and talk about the front and rear disc brakes. Now, they don't have any kind of name brand to them. They're just kind of a generic brake. But one thing I do like about the calipers is they have full-size pads opposed to the little bitty round brake pad. And that was like on the Genesis from Walmart. A couple of different Walmart bikes we have seen the round pad, and this has got the big square rectangular ones, and the more contact the better, especially for a bike that's this heavy. And we're going to find out how heavy it is here in a little bit. Don't forget, these tires are Chow Yang tires. Never heard of them. Chow Yang. They're 26 inches by 4.0 inches wide. They are massive tires. I can't wait to see what they do on the trails and what they do on the road. You know, not a lot of tread design on these tires, not really deep, pretty shallow actually, but that's okay. The rims and the spokes, I love it because they're gloss black. A lot of the times you see the spokes are chrome and the wheels are matte black. You see that everywhere. These ones are actually glossed, and I just love that attention to detail. And speaking of the rim department, I love the way that they punched out that aluminum wheel all the way around it, where you can see the rim tape and like the protrusion of the tube in there. That is a really cool little attention to detail touch that I like. Pretty cool. But yeah, that whole wheel set is really neat looking. Let's go ahead and move on to the pedals, and then we'll talk about the handlebar area and all that. The pedals are just simple plastic slimline Mongoose branded pedals, and they have reflectors in them as well. I guess it's what to be expected, you know, plastic pedals, nothing wrong with that. It doesn't have big old cleats on there. I've been shinning myself a lot lately. Not big old cleats, I'm digging that. Let's go ahead and talk about the handlebars. All right, so something interesting to be noted first on these handlebars. I did measure them, and they measure out right at 28 inches wide, and I will convert that to millimeters for you guys. But before we get into the grips and everything else, let's talk about this stem and something interesting with it. So the stem is a 90 millimeter in length with a 15 degree rise. Now the forked steer tube is a 28.6, which is pretty universal in bikes, right? you pretty much, you can go on the internet and look at a bike stem, and chances are you're going to find that the steer tube on your stem that you're looking at purchasing is a 28.6. But something that you don't normally see a lot of, if you're looking at upgrading your stem to maybe something a little bit shorter or something cooler looking, beware, because the clamp size is completely different on these bars. They may look the same as other bars, but they are not. Now, that clamp size is a 24.2 clamp. What we normally see in mountain bike clamp size bars is a 31.8. This is a 24.2. So if you are looking at upgrading your stem, make sure your clamp size is a 24.2. Or you can just go ahead and get new handlebars and you can get a new stem. And then you can have a 28.6 in the back, a 31.8 in the front, and then, of course, your bar being a 31.8 on the clamp side. And remember, we do have some upgrades over there, and one of them is a bar. So make sure you guys stick around. I'll show you all about that bar that we're going to be installing on the Malus. So that's just something to keep noted. It is a 4-bolt stem, which I do like. Don't have too good of luck with the 2-bolt stems, at least when it comes to taking it down the cat's meow. Got the good old reflector on there. Probably going to keep it on there. The brakes are Power branded, I guess some generic brand. Power branded brakes, and the shifter is unbranded as well. Now the grips are Mongoose branded grips. They feel really good in the hand. We will find out more in that real-time review. Let's go ahead and weigh this bike, the all-steel bike. I don't know, what do you guys think it's going to weigh? I'm thinking it's going to be somewhere around 50 pounds. I mean, this thing is heavy. Whew, it's a heavy bike. Not as heavy as I thought it was going to be. 43.60. All right, so that is a pretty heavy bike. Now with our upgrades, I wish I could say, oh man, we're gonna lighten this thing up, but it's not that kind of bike. The upgrades I got sitting over there, we're about to go over, they are going to make this bike a lot heavier, at least one of them in particular, I'm sure. But I got a magnet out. The handlebars are metal. The stem is actually aluminum. I did not see that coming. The wheels are aluminum. I was kind of wondering if really punching out those holes made a huge difference, which I'm sure it did as far as saving weight goes, but if it had been steel, I'm sure it would have saved a bunch on weight, but they are aluminum. The crank arms, they are aluminum as well, and the pedals, of course, are plastic. It looks like the areas where they could have really made a difference in weight, or just at least contributed to it, to taking some weight away from it, they've done. You know, aluminum, 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 and then they got those bars. And that big old nasty heavy kickstand back there. That thing might come off. I'm not sure yet. But anyway, let's go ahead and talk about some of the teasers, right? Before we do our little ender here. Let's go ahead and talk about the first upgrade. Be a new stem. Now this stem, kind of like we talked about earlier with this stem and kind of the bar department, it's got a 28.6 on the back side and a 31.8 millimeter on the front side. Don't really want you guys to see it, so I'm holding it back here. And upgrading the handlebars, I got some Race Face budget handlebars in the mail here recently. And these guys here were pretty cheap. They even come with a sticker. Race Face handlebars will be on the Malus Stage 1 upgrades, right? And I'm going to save that one for last. This one here, this is a company Geo handguards that sent us this package for this bike. Now, these are some Thrasher handguards that help protect your hands. And told the guys I would love to be putting these on the Malus. So, Geo handguards. Be prepared to see these on the Malus, on those new bars. They're a pretty cool design. You guys have to check these guys out. Geo handguards, pretty neat deal. Main event, I'm going to call it the main event. Get ready for this, guys. It's going to be a quick flash, right? Don't miss it. Ready? Big teaser. Woo! Check out them forks, baby. Those things are going to be great. I got those ordered probably a day or two after I got the bike ordered. It's going to make it look mean. Those things probably weigh 50 pounds somewhere right around the bike. But man, this is going to be an awesome project bike, just like our other bikes. And again, can't say it enough. Thank you, 3,000 subscribers, so much for sticking with us. And if you want to be a part of the Wolf Tick Nation, hit that subscribe button. It ain't hard to do, guys. But that was another Wolf Tick video. I appreciate you guys watching, man. A lot of you guys out there commenting, watching, giving the thumbs up. Notifications are on. We really appreciate it. And man, look in the description for a Buy Us a Cup of Coffee link if you'd like to support our channel in more ways than one, than just subscribing, commenting, and thumbing up. If you don't think that's enough, buy us some coffee. But we appreciate it, guys. And this Malus, as heavy as it is going to be a fun project. I can't wait to do the real-time review on it and add some of those beautiful upgrades over there, some of those GEO handguards, the stem. It's going to be great. But yeah, that's it, guys, on the Malus, the 3,000 subscriber bike.